Hello there, this is Taja Ethereal with Bolin Models and the latest edition of the wonderful Cam Model Podcast, Shit Guys Say to Cam Girls. And our tonight's guest is the wonderful Naomi Courtney, back for like the third or fourth time now. I don't know, but I love talking to you. Just say hello to everybody. What's up, girl?
Hi.
good. I'm sorry, it took a little bit longer. I was listening to our test run. Everything was great. Everything was fine. I was like, perfect volumes. And then my TV monitor went black.
Oh, no.
I have a monitor set up to my my laptop for this one. But it turns out it was just unplugged. So I had like a mini meltdown in like 2 minutes.
Oh, yeah, I can imagine.
You know, like when you like do a tech support or not when you do tech support, when like, you call in somewhere and they're like, they always ask you like, you're like, hey, my Kindle doesn't work. My computer doesn't work. And they're like, is it plugged in? And you're like,
yeah.
They always ask that question. And you're just like, that's a stupid fucking question. Why are you asking me that? Well, I just had that moment. It wasn't plugged in. So now I get it.
Yeah.
Now I know why they asked that question. So anyways, let me stop rambling. I always do that when I just talk to you. So how are you doing tonight?
Good. Super good.
Good.
How are you?
Like that. I'm doing all right. I'm relaxed.
Yay.
I was telling you during our test call, I have like 3 podcasts lined up for tonight. So I was just in a mood. I hadn't done enough. And we're going to do this one. Just talk, you know, shoot the shit, catch up a little bit. What's going on in Cam Land? And then the next one I'm going to do, I have confirmed, is going to be with Kendi Cumming. We're going to talk about some other stuff about, you know, women of color and camming and so forth. So,
okay.
Yeah, man, it's not going to be heavy. So if anybody wants to stick around for that one, we're just going to be like talking about it. Like, is it possible to make money? Which the answer is yes. Fuck yes, it is.
Definitely.
Yeah. So she and I are going to get into that later on tonight, but I just want to have some fun with you because you're so cool and I like talking to you. Yeah. So what's new? What's going on in your neck of the woods with camming?
Oh, with camming or just in general?
In general, whatever you want to talk about. You know, like you were saying, you're regularly on streaming. How did you, the last contest, how long was that for?
Like Memorial Day weekend? Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. That was the most recent contest. I'm not on streaming that much anymore, so I hear things, but I'm not sure.
Oh, I wasn't really on at all, to be honest. I usually contest, it's not that I avoid them, it's just that I happen to be doing other stuff when they're going on, so I totally miss them, usually.
I don't know, I was wondering, because I was talking to, like most people know, this podcast is sponsored by Bolin Models, which is a daily pay studio, one of the top sites, I believe, like in the top 5, that are doing really well and performing well in the program are Stream 8. Manny Vids is another one. Sky Private, which we actually, you can sign up and use Sky Private with Bolin Models and get free daily pay.
So, really?
You can get free daily pay always, so it'll always be that way. The percentage might even get even higher, like a higher payout, but I don't want to say that just too prematurely. But right now it's 75%.
Very cool.
So we're noticing that cam sites are okay, cool, they're doing well, but a lot of the content sites for clip makers and stuff is doing good as well. But my point I was trying to bring back to like StreamMate was that when I talked to Bolin Models, they were saying that the numbers were down last week for a lot of people because we're going into the summertime, I guess. So
yeah,
I was just curious, maybe you were an exception to the norm or something like that.
it was good for me. I texted way more this past week than I was on cam, and that did fantastic for me. So maybe like people just with their families that can't like be on cam and just like want to text or whatever. So
wait, are you saying like, okay, but wait, you do texting through a site like it was like Chatfun, right?
Yeah, Chatfun.
Okay, so Chatfun, and then you said you did Friendly.
I do Friendly a little bit. Somewhere out of nowhere. Oh, what was the site? It was like one random site that I had gotten ChatStar, I think. ChatStar. Somebody had just, I guess, found my number or something and sent a message. And I'm like, yeah. So we just started chatting that way, too. So people are just coming out of the woodwork with the texting. It's been good.
ChatStar.
Yeah.
It's not in this ChatStar. Is ChatStar I'm trying to remember. There's so many of them, but
I know.
so like you do you advertise your texting, or you just sign up through the platform and they
I
contact
advertise ChatFun because it's the easiest to use, in my opinion, and
you?
the payout's low. Like, the amount that you have to make to get to payout now is a lot lower than it used to be. So that makes it pretty easy for me. And they just do direct deposit, so that's nice too.
Yes, that direct deposit, baby. So let me ask you a few other
Yes.
questions, like you were about the texting and stuff like that. Like we can do like through Bolin, you can do texting. Like there's some platforms we can set up pre-block sessions. I'm not a texter, but I do think it's money there, which is funny because that's texting is so old school.
I know,
It's
but guys
so
love
old
it for some
school.
reason.
It's we called it sexting or just whatever, but like.
Yeah.
It's old school, so it's phone sex, but that shit is like it's bumping. So it's like a lot of people are looking for different ways to like get off cam. Like you like to perform, but a lot of people kind of like I want to do something different to
Yeah.
supplement the income. But we're finding out like I've known all along, but more people starting to find out that there's real money
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah,
in
there's really
texting.
good money in just like texting and stuff like that. I'm curious to get started on Night Flirt just doing that because I've heard someone was doing that and was making pretty good money.
I think people can do well on it, but I don't know. I don't really do it. I don't like the idea of it. My biggest problem with the texting platforms is that I can't control how much I charge. So that right there is
Oh.
like a no for me. I don't like people trying to control my price points.
I can understand that.
Yeah,
Absolutely.
that
Yeah.
annoys me. So I'd rather not get into that. But tell me some of the stuff that like the guys say to you, like when you're texting, because I know what they say to me when I used to do it a lot, because I used to work for a phone sex company, and they offered texting packages. And like, I had this one guy who, oh my God, you go first. You tell me first, because I will go off on like a tangent on these
I think
stories.
the worst for me, I guess, if I had to pick something that was like weird or funny, I guess, is that like they're like, okay, tell me what you would do. And you just start on this dialogue because usually you have something in your mind that you're working on, right? And then you're like, okay, so I'm going to do this. And then they just jump in with something completely different that would not work in your scenario at all. Like,
Oh, you mean like they would tell you like, okay, so if I want you to talk about how you would like step on my balls, let's say it's a CBT call or something.
sure, yeah.
Yeah, and
I
they're
usually
like,
don't get
hey.
anything that strange, but yeah, so let's say that. So you're like, okay, well, I get my, heels and slowly press down or whatever. And then the guy's like, and then I grab your boobs and you're like, what? Like,
Like, yeah, no, that's not, that wasn't a part of the plan. Yeah, because they do jump around sporadically, but it's like I've learned that like, you can't really control it. You kind of have to let go. You can control it and try to start
right,
the call, the
exactly.
session, but if they start out saying things like "dominate me," and you're like, "Okay, baby, that sounds good. So, what kind of domination do you want? Like, tell me what to do." Okay,
Yeah.
sweetie. Well, let me get a little bit more questions about what kind of things you're into. So then you got to ask some questions like, "So what kind of porn do you watch?" Because that helps.
That's a good one. That's
Yeah,
super good. Yeah.
that's what I do. I
That's a
ask
super
them.
good question.
Yeah, ask them what kind of porn they like, because then you'll get a good feel for what they're into. Because some guys, it's just if you just ask them like, "What are you into?" It's like they're drawing a blank, and I guess they think that they're talking to their mom or their wife, and they don't want that, so they.
I'm deer in the headlights with that sort of thing too before. Guys are like, what's your craziest fantasy? And you're like,
Oh my
what do I
God.
say? Do I say something real or do I say something
I
like
mean, I do a
what you think
combination
that
of
they
all
want
of
to hear,
that. I do a combination of a little bit of the real shit or just make it up. Or then I have
Right.
like standby go-to stories and stuff like that. But like, I don't know. Like, I guess I kind of have had some real-time, real shit, crazy stuff happen. But I don't perceive it as being crazy, but some other people might, you know what I mean? But
Right. Oh yeah, definitely.
yeah, so like what we were talking about, like the texting. See, I'm off on a tangent with you.
No,
No,
you're good.
but yeah, so like texting is another option for like people in the summertime. Phone sex has always been an option, but like if
Yeah.
you're just getting started right now, it doesn't mean you can't make money, but like, you know, it's still an option that it's right there. Just sign up. If you're trying to do it solo independently, you're gonna need more time because it takes time to build that up.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah, it takes time. So you're probably gonna want to definitely sign up for a platform. I'm trying to think of like companies that are within Berlin. I think you can set up like a Kick or something with ManyVids.
Yeah, and then you can sell messaging by like a time period, I think. They have that option,
Can
which
you
is
do
kind
that on
of
cams? Like, I remember you used to work on cams quite a bit. I used to too, but
cool.
cams is another spot. I meant to highlight that this week. Cams, I'm not on there anymore. I'm still having my profile in there, but I am not doing free chat right now.
Oh, you're just doing the paid chat?
I'm only doing like Skype, Discord, phone sex trails. I mean, that's
Oh, okay.
usually that was mostly my background, but I've been so busy with the other stuff that I can't really get a schedule. But what I wanted to say about people who might be listening who might have an account with cams, y'all should check out cams.com because I know the numbers are up for that and that my best times of the year is cams. Crazy
Cams
enough.
is such a good site, to be honest. It was my number one site for a long time, like the only site I really used for camming, and I actually really did enjoy it. The customers are so different than streaming.
The only thing is the price points are a little lower. You might find
Yeah,
that out.
that's
You're gonna have a
true.
hard time. Like if you're one of those chicks who's used to charging like even more than $5.99, you're gonna have a hard time with cams. You know what I'm
Oh yeah,
saying? But
definitely.
what I did notice is that you'll have, for me anyways, I would have multiple people in my chat at a time. So if you did like the group chat, it would be nothing to have three people. So if you got three people going at $3.99, $4.99, $5.99, that's more than charging $9.99 a minute for one person or whatever.
Very true, yeah.
So I mean, there's different hustles for different sites, but cams, when I thought about it, because I was on there for a couple of years and I looked at my numbers, when other people were talking about how slow it was when it dropped down in the summertime, cams was always bumping for me. So I think when I get my schedule together, because I'm relocating finally, getting situated back in Florida.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, thank God,
That's
finally.
exciting. Yeah,
So now that I'll be back and I'll have a different schedule, I think cams is probably gonna be the spot that I'm gonna go back to and like
that's exciting.
and invest some
I
time
really
in.
love you.
Yeah. So sorry.
Oh, you're good.
My throat was like going off of me. I need to
Oh.
maintain because I got like two more
Oh
podcasts to
my gosh. Like tea or something, I guess.
do. So we were talking about going into the summertime and
Yeah.
like how it can be slow, how to make additional money, and then you got all the other drama with the payment issues. Oh my gosh.
I know.
We're still dealing with the payment issues because First Choice, they shit the bed several months ago and they still owe a lot of people money.
That's what's so scary. I'm afraid for some people that's gone. Like,
Yeah.
ugh.
I'm wondering like, do we have an e-passport? When you don't know what e-passport was, that was like one of the original sex worker friendly payment processors. Which we've come a long way since then, but they basically just shut down taking money from performers, affiliates, campsites. They just, boom, people never got their money back for them. They got too big, too fast, and just took off of the money. And I'm wondering, I think I have a feeling that First Choice may have done that because they owe a lot of companies money. They owe individual, I mean, like thousands of dollars they owe people. So,
Yeah, that's so crazy.
yeah.
It's so sad.
So now there's CosmoPay, which I regretfully say that I actually endorsed it for StreamMate, because that's what I thought, that was a new option, and everyone was excited about it. So now I have to go and update some of the things I wrote because apparently they're not doing too well either. Yeah, and I don't know why. It's like have you like you've read like there's a particular thread about it, the conversation about a lot, mostly a lot of European models.
Because that's their only option, really.
Yeah, because like a lot of these companies don't offer a direct deposit, and I'm just like, why not?
Yeah, I don't even have a clue. It's so crazy.
I don't get it. So some companies like StreamMate, they're only offering, I think, check right now. It's only a paycheck. You can only get a paycheck, or if you're with Berlin Models, you can have other options because the money goes to them, and then you can get paid out via direct deposit, Paxum, transfer wise.
Mm-hmm.
There may be a few other little options they do like on a case by case basis or something like that, but mostly the main ones are like Paxson, TransferWise, and Direct Deposit. But you have to be in a studio to
Yeah.
get that hooked up. But you know, some campsites have direct deposit. Like I believe CAMS is one of them.
I think Cam says, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of them. So I don't understand why Stream ain't one of the biggest sites around. They don't have it set up. So I don't know. But I feel bad for a lot of the camels. I don't know. I don't have anything to offer to helpful, to be helpful.
I don't either, unfortunately. I
Yeah.
imagine. I just couldn't imagine having like working so hard and then having all your money locked up. And
Yes.
like, I don't know. Like, I just don't know where it's at. Like,
Yeah, and
but the
having the
bills are still
money.
coming up too, you know? Oh my God.
Yeah, and the money is locked up. But not only is the was the money locked up from First Choice, but then another option presented itself, a savior, which was CosmoPay, and it's turned around to be fucked up all over again. So it's like they got fucked twice. And then you're finding out that CosmoPay is some roundabout way, a subsidiary for Payoneer, First Choice Pay. They're all connected, so it's like the
Oh,
same
that
thing.
really was true. I heard that rumor and I didn't
Yeah,
know if that was true or not. Oh my God.
there's like it's like the same freaking company.
Oh my God.
No,
Wow.
we didn't know it either, but like it's like looking at it like you know, so they got
Wow.
screwed over by the same people. Kind of like it's a little more complicated than that, but it's like, oh my gosh. So now people are just like wondering what the fuck they're gonna do. But I can give one tip for people who right now are US based, who are trying to get direct deposit, who are trying to get bank accounts. That some people are saying that some companies like Wells Fargo is under attack. They kind of should be because of all the crooked shit they've done.
Sure, absolutely.
Yeah, making fake accounts and stuff like that. But then there's Bank of America because they're having all these new bills that are setting up. Basically, they say it's for to target sex traffickers using bank accounts. Hello, they
Oh,
don't use
no.
bank accounts, whatever.
Yeah.
So, yeah, so a bank that could help, something that can help, that will take money from certain institutions is Netspend, MetaBank.
Okay.
It's a prepaid card. It has
Right,
just an
right,
ACH. It has a routing accounting number. So if you're trying to get money and you have, if you have like a Wells Fargo or Bank of America or any of the other major banks, you may not want to have all of your banking details from adult services going to those accounts. Wherever you have your savings, you probably don't want to send money from whatever, because it's probably not safe because they could possibly at some point freeze your account and hold your money. You know what
Yeah.
I mean? So that's it may not happen right away, but it has happened in the past. Just Google Operation
Sure.
Choke Point. Operation Choke Point. Google it. It's happening again. So
Yeah.
one thing I can suggest is that right now, Netspend cards are not doing that. So whatever prepaid card service check cashing place in your neighborhood, this is like a hood. This is like some ghetto ass advice. It's like hood. This is
Oh,
like hood.
yeah.
This is hood style shit right there for you. Get one of them cards, get your money sent to those cards, and then take your money off the card and then walk your ass into the bank, the ATM, and deposit your money. Because it's getting more difficult, obviously. But yeah, don't just think like, oh well, I've had Chase Bank for several years. Nothing's gonna happen to me, or I've got
Yeah.
Wells Fargo. And that's, psh, trust me, they will come for you, especially if you make a lot of money. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, and you have multiple deposits. Like for me, I'm on KnifeLer and I have several different accounts. So that's different deposits, you know, multiple
Oh,
times a
yeah.
week. And then you have stuff coming from whatever company that they can just Google and see like, what is this service? It's like it's flagged already. So
Right.
be smart out there, y'all, when you're trying to get your money. Sorry to be a doomsday bitch,
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you just can't put it all in one place, unfortunately.
don't put all your money. I'm not saying you gotta like put it and bury it in a tomato field or nothing, or
Stick it
keep
under
it
the
under the
mattress.
mattress, under the mattress, yes. But don't keep all your money in the same bank account. You know what I mean? Like if you have, like, because a lot of us, we work for different companies. Maybe send, money that you might get from Bullen Models to one bank account, and then money that may not be in Bullen Models, send that to another bank account. You got to have a backup for your backup, because it's getting serious out here. I mean, the business, and that's crazy because the economy is steady, business is good, but they're just squeezing us and they're making it harder for us to get our money. So you're gonna have to get creative.
For sure, for sure.
So yeah, that's all I have for that right there. I feel like I'm gone into a dark, deep hole.
No, that's good.
But those are the things that people are talking about, because I usually like pay attention to the conversations that are in the forums and so forth. So
Yeah.
yeah, that seems to be like the biggest concern. Like, who knew? Like, well, we should have known. We knew it was coming. Like all the things with FOSTA and all the conversations, but like, who knew that it was gonna like get this bad? Like, I know I didn't think it was
I didn't think it'd be this fast. Like
this
it was
fast,
like,
right?
yeah. It just went, the ball just started rolling and it just went crazy. It's so fast. It was so weird.
Like, I mean, honestly, I'll be completely honest. Like, I myself have not experienced, for this go around, I've not really had to endure any hardships. But because I remember hearing the stories and preparing for it, I have multiple bank accounts, like I said, with different like prepaid cards, maybe some of my hood shit that I remember from back in the day. Remember having to hustle different things, so I remember how the I knew what to do when I knew the shit was about to hit the fan. Like, I've been in this for a long time, so I haven't had any real hardships yet. So, but I see a lot of other babies out there who are just freaking out, and I want to give them
Yeah, they
all a
just
hug.
weren't prepared for it. 'Cause I mean, if you come in during a time where everything's good and you just get the same payment every week, it's nice, then you just don't expect that anything serious would happen to it. I mean, you don't go to a normal job, I guess, and get a paycheck, and then one day they're like, oh, well, the payment processor's gone, so you're not getting paid. It's like, what?
Yeah, the payment processor. And then also when you do, and it's like, and it's crazy because we're doing this by the book. We're all like, it's not illegal. We're not criminals. Like, it's not, we're not doing anything. We're not out on the street. We're not soliciting on the streets or anything. We're like quiet, like happy, whatever, robust people living, working from home and doing what we want to do with consensual people. And it's just like,
It's they're like, nope, you gotta stop that.
yeah. So yeah, that's been really crazy. But on the positive side, I've done some little transitional work. I made a little video for because people were asking me about, because I did some different stuff for my website, or how I was taking payments and so forth, and selling my content. For a while, for like the last year, I've used, actually maybe 2 years, I think my primary was IndieBill, which is another part of the Bullion Models network. IndieBill, we all know who IndieBill is. I think they have 85% payouts. They handle all chargebacks, provided that you pass their security fraud protection, which I think is pretty easy to
Yeah, I've
pass.
never really had an issue with it, but
I haven't either. I think if there is an issue, they're pretty open to communication, and they basically give you the guidelines if they have suspected there might be something foul play. But you just got to kind of comply with it, work with them, and then move along. But
sure.
they actually have, where people don't know, like they have hosting, where you can host your content, instant downloads. You can create a payment page
Yes.
for IndieBill. And what else do they do? I feel like I'm missing something.
You said you can upload your own videos to sell. You can do Skype or Snapchat or whatever, that sort of thing. And then, yeah, you can do like customs, I guess, or like just have them tip or sell whatever.
Through the
As
tribute
long as
page.
it's not a physical object, you can't ship anything anymore.
That's right. That they, for a while, that they were allowing that, but like if you want to sell panties or something like that. I don't really think anyone is really no platform. I think maybe Mannyvids
I think you're right.
does.
I think they still allow it.
But for now,
Yeah, I don't.
yeah.
So I guess I haven't heard anything different, but I don't really do a lot of that, so.
Yeah, me either. Every now and again, but like that's sort of like a solo indie girl type stuff. But yeah,
Right.
they're still good. I like them. There's some indie bill I'm talking about, but like there's some things I would like to see. I want to see them do a shopping cart and they can put multiple things in there or whatever.
Yeah, that would be super, especially for like clips.
Yeah, it's like multiple clips instead of like one transaction at a time. I know they said they're working on that, working on that. But what I was saying is I made a video recently about Webstream.
Oh yeah, I saw that you had posted that. I haven't watched a thing for it yet.
Oh, well, thank you very much. I'm just kidding.
No. Jeez, I guess I should have done my homework.
It's all good, girl. But no, I made like a video because some people were asking me like what that was going to be about. It's basically Webstream. It's a company from the UK. You can set up studio options. I don't know if they're going to come to bullet models yet because they're trying to catch up from other crap. And hopefully soon they'll have that. So basically what it is you can host your content. You can live stream directly from your website through just Camit, which is really
Oh,
popular
okay.
for adult work, or they have another one called Cam Connect. You can take phone sex calls with a phone sex call module, like something very similar to Verify Call. The only thing they don't have is texting.
Oh, okay.
They don't have that, so that's what I'm using, and it's going really well. It was kind of a transition trying to get guys who go to my site to get on board because they're like little puppies. They get confused. When
Yeah.
you move, when you move, when you move things around, you have to kind of retrain them. So finally, they're getting on board. So yeah, I'm excited about that right now for the Cami company. They're not new, by the way, but a lot of people in the U.S. don't quite know about them yet.
I've heard about them vaguely, but I haven't heard about anybody doing anything with it, really.
Yeah, it's like another option for like Model Central. If you want to go to
Yeah,
a membership site, but they don't, it's not a membership site, it's for individual downloads, which is what I prefer anyways. So I don't know why I started talking about that. Whenever I talk to you, I just like start rambling because I feel like I'm talking to like somebody I know, like right here in front of me.
it's good. I can't complain about that.
I don't know. It's a good thing, obviously. But yeah, I just like started reading. I lose my train of thought and everything. But yeah, so that's Camland in a nutshell right now. It's full of chaos, but there's still money out there. You know what I
Yeah.
mean? There's still money. Like, I have guys who are showing up, hit me up on Discord and Skype, wanting to do shows, guys I haven't seen or heard from
Oh,
in
yeah.
several months. So it's like there's money to be made. It's just the problem is getting your money.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I've seen like a surge of new people who are signing up with Bolin or people who hit me up on a Twitter account wanting to
Good.
know more info. Yeah, so that's really, really good. More people are signing up, trying to figure out how to get paid. We have TransferWise, which is working really good for
Awesome.
Canadian cam models. I do think that I think they have solutions for just about anyone
That's what I've heard,
across the
yeah.
world, but I think the Russian cameras might still be having some issues because we had a lot of Russian BBs, not a whole lot, a lot, but quite a few, and I think they're still running into issues trying to find a solution for
Yeah,
them.
it's varied, and that and Romania are both
I don't
pretty
know.
tough.
I have to ask. I have to find out about that one. I don't know specifically if it's they're having a hard time paying
Maybe
Romanian
not. I
cam
guess it's just
models.
what I've heard from other people, but I guess it depends on how you want to be paid too.
Yep, that's the truth. Because it's
Yeah.
like if you don't want to get a bank account and you want other options, like if you're trying to do like the third party, you know what I really think? What I'm starting to realize, and sadly, because I like having Pioneer, who turned into My Choice, then try to reboot as Cosmopay. I like having those third party cards for I like it as an option. But there's so many fees involved. Like it's $3 per load, $5 in some cases if you want it immediately. Then it's like these arbitrary fees that you don't really know what it's going to be every time you do a withdrawal at the ATM. But they were convenient. For instance, if you wanted like daily pay, if you wanted your money on the weekend or something.
I used to use them until about a year ago, so.
But then I noticed like when I move over to direct deposit, then there's like you really it starts to add up. You start doing that 3 times, 4 or 5 times a week. Then you multiply that 4 times, and like your next thing you know, you're damn near like at $50.
It's so crazy.
You don't realize it at first, but what I'm starting to realize is I think those third party cards are going to be obsolete. I think you're going to need to have a bank account. You're going to need to have a bank account, so.
Yeah, I mean, even the prepaid cards here that you get at the gas station or, check cashing place or whatever have less fees than them. It's like, come on,
Yep,
what?
exactly. But you have to put your information on those cards.
That's true,
I'm going to write up something tonight because I'm going to be like working through the night. I'm going to write something up about the details of like using check cashing prepaid cards as an option versus a bank. I am because I believe in it. I mean, it's worked for me all these years, but you never
Oh yeah,
know.
I've totally used them before too. I really do love them. I don't I do like my bank account for sure, but yeah, the old-fashioned prepaid card, that's it sometimes.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm gonna do a little write-up on the differences and so forth and what the pros and cons of using those are versus the bank account. Don't use them to replace your bank account. You probably might want to have several different ones, 2 or 3 of them. But just this is what we're at right now. So then have them sent there for the companies that do pay direct deposit. But you can use those for like Boolean models because they have, like I said, a routing accounting number and it's an ACH, so it all works and so forth. But yeah,
I
that's
wonder
it.
if
What
they
it
still have
is.
the Rush card. Do you remember those commercials?
Yes, that's what I'm gonna that's on my list.
Oh
That's
man.
owned by Russell Simmons. I know he got
Yes,
some.
and you could get one with like Fat Farm or like Baby Fat or whatever on the card. That's what I was thinking about. I was like, oh man, I might want one.
Oh my God. I think what about Green Dot? Does Green Dot give you an accounting and a routing number?
I think so.
That might be an
I know
option.
Bluebird does. Bluebird's the one Walmart owns, and if you go use the ATM in the Walmart or like or at the checkout or something where you take out cash, that's free. Like you don't pay fees on that.
Bluebird, isn't that American Express?
Yeah, that's American Express.
But in they're like the official Walmart card.
Yeah, Walmart does it
Girl,
with
thank you. Because that's like you're giving me something else to research, but yeah, Rush Cards, that was Russell Simmons, but I remember he got so much shit for that because of the fees were so high. I never had one,
I never had one either, but I was
but
watching
he
the
got a
commercial.
lot of shit because people were like, he was representing it. He was like promoting it for like a card for the people, for the culture, and they were like, how you charging the people all this money, my man? So
Yeah,
but I don't know, but I'll look and see if that's still around. But like
I'm so curious about
there's so many different options. Well, okay, we have come to the end of this podcast. I love talking to you.
that now.
If let me see, what was I gonna say? Never mind, I'll just do that with the next podcast. I was about to go off on another tangent. Like I always do, I talk too much.
It's super good.
So yeah, thank you so much, Naomi, for coming back.
Thank you.
Tell people again how they can find you on the interwebs.
Probably your best bet is naomicourtney.com because I know how to spell that as opposed to my Twitter name, apparently. So,
What do you mean? You don't
because
know how to spell your Twitter?
I thought of it. This has haunted me for like probably months. Like I was thinking because I had said my Twitter name before and how to spell it out, and I'm pretty sure I got it wrong the last time. So I'm like, no, I know I will not screw it up if I just say my full name
Well,
as
spell
well.
Naomi. Spell, because they might not know, girl. Spell it. Spell it
No,
out.
don't make me do this. Naomi.
In Courtney.com.
See? I was like, oh God.
That's not hard. It could have been like NAMEE or something like that. So that's why I was
Oh
like
yeah, I guess. Yeah.
NAO.
Am I? Yeah, Naomi.
MI. Naomi. Courtney.com. She's awesome. She can find her on streaming. What's your streaming name?
It's the same. It's Naomi Courtney.
Nice.
I know,
Easy.
right?
Simple. People can find you anywhere.
I hope so.
Yeah. So, okay, this is the end of our latest episode of Shit Guys Say to Cam Girls. I'm Taja Ethereal, and I'm with Naomi Courtney. We've already established that, and we are out. Thank you so much, girl. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.